Restoring data in Veeam Backup for Microsoft 365 is super easy and very flexible. First, all you need to do is define the restore scope. You can do this by selecting the job, which will pull in everything within that job role, or by selecting the entire organization and hitting explore. You can select the application you wish to explore from here, whether or not it's Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive for Business, or Microsoft Teams. If you know a specific point in time you'd like to restore data back from, you can also do that from here. And if the user has been deleted or is an old user in the system, you can also browse the data by checking this box. Let's take a look at the Explorer itself. So, coming down through the menu, you can expand each one of these items and the inbox, the calendar, the notes, and any other data spooled underside Microsoft Exchange can be found in this window. There are a couple of options for restoring data. You can either restore the entire mailbox, which will overwrite everything inside of that mailbox. You can restore that mailbox to a new location. So if you need to delegate rights to the items, maybe from someone that's left the company or changed positions, you can do that here, as well as export any of this data to either PST or directly to the desktop. Keep in mind, you will need a version of Outlook 2010 or newer installed on this machine in order to generate that PST file for you. If you know more specifically what mail item you're looking for, you can select any item within that mailbox and right-click on that mailbox item itself. You'll get a few additional items from here. Restoring to the desktop, or saving to the desktop, saving as an MSG file, and using send with an email account. Sending with an email account will attach this file to an email and send it out to whoever may be requesting that data. To compare these properties, you simply need to select your preferred authentication method. In this case, we're going to use the one-time password app authentication mode. And this will take us to the Microsoft logon. We'll post that code. And this will authenticate we are who we say we are and give us access rights to be able to compare to production data. And as you can see, we've been authenticated, and now this will compare this email item to what we have in the backup compared to what is in the production environment. As we can see, nothing's changed between production and here, but this can be very useful, especially in cases where you're looking for changed items, or you have multiple items selected and you need to see the differences in those properties. Next, we'll be taking a look at the Restore portal. The Restore portal is the way to get in with Restore operators. And we'll sign in with that same email account and select the scope. Since I'm a Restore operator and Restore admin, I can restore everything within my defined scope inside the console. So we can select, say, Violet, then define which restore point we want to restore based off of, and we can delegate the restore back to the original location by adding it to our restore session. So we'll select this item. Even if we do select new locations, this will only allow us to send to the same mailbox, which helps prevent any type of breach or exfiltration of data. Reason can be defined here. Once you've confirmed everything in the summary is what you need, you can hit finish, and this will restart the restore process for you. If you'd like to watch the restore process, simply click the restore here. And see, it's already done.